pick me a plum. You came along and everything's starting to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come.
You are in for a treat at home and in the studio audience. We have a man here that almost needs no introduction. If you have been on YouTube, then you may know this guy. CNN execs watch this guy. People call him from all over the world. You don't believe me? Take a look at this clip.
Just ignorant. I tell my wife, anyone, you walk around here with them high heel shoes, you're just a prostitute. I don't care who. It could be my wife. It could be my daughter. It might be my mama. Got no bill with no high heel shoes. Oh, that for a prostitute. Amen. Too many preachers have gone out and called the name of God, and they made mockery of the minister. I'm not going to be one of them.
That's right.
Natural retardation, you can't help that. That's a birth defect. But you don't have to be spiritually retarded.
That's right. Amen.
That's a problem.
That's right.
I tell all of them, every preacher preaching false doctrine, you sleep.
Amen. That's right.
They sleep.
That's right.
They rubbing these people, got all these stores and conventions, and these old lying, old fuck your old gay preachers, you're bringing in these old singers in there, and they damning the people.
Amen.
They know the women more emotional. And Lord, they go to shout. Titties be everywhere. I'm going to keep it real. These men know why they love me in the church. They see rock shaking, rolling on the floor, ain't got no drawers on, everything. They're talking about, look at the spirit of error. How many white people you see walking around with weaving in their hair? About us.
That's right.
Because they have taught us we got to look like them in order to fit. We got to look like these people to fit in nowhere.
That's right.
God made us.
That's right.
Honey, being the son said, know you that the Lord, he is God.
That's right.
It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves.
That's right.
Jeremiah, you need to be in jail. Paula White, you need to be in jail. Every cricket preacher, Earl Polk, you need to be in jail. White and black, Jake need to be in jail. Long need to be in jail. Paul Money, go, Jake. Get his brother with the jail curl. Lock him up, too.
Amen.
They just came out on television and told these retarded women that those heels don't come up and it causes a health problem.
Amen.
They showed a white woman on TV. I know you believe it, a white woman done it. She got to get disability. She can't even be an airline steward no more because she can't walk from wearing them high heel shoes. I've been told you got you like a prostitute.
Amen.
Isn't that right?
That's right.
I got a stand. I teach a woman how to adorn her body.
Amen.
I teach that here. No eyebrow arching, no cutting your hair, no painting your lip, no natural lipstick, no fingernail polish. Cover your toe, cover your bottle, cover the foot, and wash your behind and brush your teeth.
That's
me talking.
That's right.
I told them, brother, I think I be in that gym, y'all see me fall out, and some sister running out with a medic uniform, tell you gonna give me mouth to mouth. Y'all let me go home with Jesus. Sister got me cupped in the back of the head like this, yeah, tongue in my mouth. Get him and pick a phone.
That's right.
Trying to get you get in there and wash your monkey behind.
That's right.
I'll tell you one thing, burn me up. I'm going to be honest with y'all. This is my pet peeve. A stinking woman.
That's right.
Nasty woman. Woo! I'm sorry, I can do it by myself. I ain't lying. I'm not lying. I can't take it. Now, can anybody help me out and tell me what is my problem?
Now you see exactly what I'm talking about. With me today is Pastor Tony Smith. He is the senior pastor of, you love this name, the Way of God Church of the Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Did I say that right?
Oh, yeah. You said it correctly.
But why don't you say it?
The Way of God Church of the Lord Jesus.
I like the way you say it.
Well, thank the Lord.
In Atlanta, Georgia. And you may say, okay, what's the big deal? The big deal about you is you are extremely opinionated. I mean, and you don't mix words at all. You are just really, let's just get into it.
Well, I guess basically what it is the way I deliver the doctrine to people and I express to people how we got to get back to the fundamentals of the Bible. When people say they're Bible believers, a lot of things that people are doing, we left it. You know, they'll say what's outdated and what's not done this day and time, but yet the Constitution is still good, which was written supposedly by our forefathers hundreds of years ago. Yet if you go to court today, they're going to judge you according to no principles. Yet when we use the Bible, we throw things out and say we're in a different age, we're in a different time, we got a different move going. But God has always remained the same.
This is true. But there's some things that you don't agree with. And we can, and let's talk about it, because you talk about it very openly. You do not believe that women should wear weaves.
Where do we begin?
We can begin right there. Because I'm going to be honest with you. I love my hair.
Oh, yep.
And I'm just going to be honest. My hair is just very, very soft. It is very, very soft. It does not hold a curl. And my stylist told me, like, Lexi, you are burning out your hair. You're just, like, totally burning it out because it won't hold a curl, meaning that I'll curl it, spend 45 minutes, Pastor, curling my hair. I'll go outside. If there's 1% humidity, ladies, you know this, my hair falls before I get to church.
There are reasons why God has given us certain standards of living, being the people that we are. We just introduced ourselves into a lot of things because of the culture whom we deal with. We're dealing in America, so in America, people just tend to take on a look as they see more Caucasians go to. That's not our natural hair color, our natural stability of our hair, trying to do what we see other people do. The way our hair is designed for a reason, for the region we come from. Our hair is made to repel heat. We can't wear hair like Caucasians. They come from more of a northern area, so that's why their hair can grow, and they grow their hair and it's straight. We have a natural due to our hair, and we got to come back to it. And a lot of these things that we wouldn't do them, we wouldn't burn our hair out.
Hark.
Okay. So you're saying, now, let's go here. If I wear hair that is not mine, you made a statement.
Oh, did I?
Pastor Smith, yeah, you made a statement, sir, that you said that you could catch AIDS by wearing other people's hair.
Well, I mean, you know, the AIDS virus, even when a person dies, even when a person dies, the virus is still alive. And a lot of time we're taking on putting other people's hair into our head, we don't know what we're introducing. So, you know, a lot of things they tell us, they tell you condoms are safe, but yet when people are still kissing, you still can transmit AIDS. There are a lot of things that people do, and they try to make an excuse for it. But when you really get back down, if people will learn how everybody is made differently, everybody not going to have the same length of hair. Thank God for what he's giving you. Appreciate what the Most High has given you. But most people don't. They tend to look at what other people have and begin to covet. And covet is a sin even in the Bible. What we try to teach, and stand with biblical principles, in 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 9, Paul specifically began to speak to the church on how women should adorn themselves with modest, with shamefacedness. That's not a proud look. I mean, people say, well, I have bad skin, I was burned or whatever. That doesn't change who you're on the inside. If you don't have a good feel about who you're on the inside, no matter what you put on the outside, you're still going to be miserable. And we have this illusion that we can go out with made-up faces and hair and eyes, and it really covers who we are on the inside.
You said you made a statement that if a woman got beat up, do you remember saying this? Because her man didn't want her going out looking all painted up, and he thought it was too much because she was trying to be too haughty, then she got what she got.
I don't think I said that. I don't know if I said that. I don't
agree
with men beating women. You'll show them the clip.
I'll show them.
You can show them to them, but I don't believe in a man beating on a woman. The only way I teach my brethren, I do teach that a man can beat a woman. And what I teach me can be. Hold, let me finish. When it comes down to providing for the home, beat them. You get there and you get to work first and make sure you're paying the bill. When it comes down to setting a standard in the home, beat them. You ought to be example in your home. When a man physically put his hands on a woman, I totally disagree with that. I don't agree with that.
You almost got shot up here tonight. You know that, right?
I asked you for a helmet before I got here. And y'all still got to love me when it's over.
You said that Bible schools, the seminary,
yes,
messing people up.
I totally agree with
you. You don't agree with seminary?
I don't.
Why?
Because,
I don't get it.
Well, a lot of times you start dealing with logic, and that kills people. When you look at biblically, and it goes right back. It's amazing how we can take the Bible and we want to raise money, bring y'all the tithes into the storehouse, robbing God. But when it comes down to other things he say, we just, you know, casually throw it out of the door. The Sabbath, there's so many different things we throw out of the door when we don't want to do it.